Welcome to our daily devotion. It's Saturday, May 30th, and this is day 74 of our temporary pause of on-campus activities in response to the coronavirus pandemic. Last Monday night, I was just as disturbed as you were to watch the video of George Floyd on the Minneapolis street with a police officer with his knee wedged in his neck. I actually had a chance to watch the whole 9-minute video, and I watched a man die in front of my very eyes. There's something that happened that night that I haven't heard the media talk about, but that's an important thing for us Christians to remember, and that's the word partiality. Now, that police officer had a piece of metal on his uniform. That medal represented an oath that he took to uphold the constitutional rights of every citizen and guest in the city of Minneapolis. He was charged to protect those rights and to make sure that everyone had equal access to them. But on that particular night, he disregarded that. Instead, that badge became a license for him, if you will, to show partiality. Partiality is when I think I'm better than you, and either I deserve better treatment than you do, or that I can do whatever I wish regardless of what you think. And that police officer certainly was doing whatever he wished, regardless of what the young man was saying on the ground to be able to breathe, and what innocent bystanders were trying to plead with the officer not to do. Partiality is something that is intolerable. Believe it or not only in our society, but also in the Christian church. Let me tell you why. If you look at the Bible at James chapter 2, verses 8 through 9, we read this. If you really fulfill the royal law, according to the scripture, you shall love your neighbor as yourself, you are doing well. But if you show partiality, you are committing sin and are convicted by the law as transgressors. Now, COVID-19 certainly took away our privilege of gathering together in the sanctuary for worship. But we're going to regather again in 3 weeks. And once again, we'll be around one another in worship and as we go through the summer in other activities. But let's go ahead and leave something behind in the garbage can, not the recycler, the garbage can. And that's partiality. That officer in Minneapolis obviously exercised partiality in a horrible, evil way that resulted in a murder. But here at Epiphany, we can't show partiality either. That means that when we look around at a worship service or interact with one another, we, as an individual, you and me, are no better than any other member, guest, or friend here. We don't deserve any more privileges than anyone else does as a Christian in Christ's house of worship. And secondly, just because we may have credentials, maybe how long we've been a member of the Lutheran Church or here at Epiphany, how long we've been a Christian, how much we know about the Bible, never makes us better than anyone else and gives us the right of partiality where we can do whatever we want, regardless of what someone else thinks. Partiality is not what Christ commands us to do. So when we gather together in several weeks, let's leave it behind and be the people whom God has called us to be. I invite you to bow your heads for prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray that you would bring peace to the city of Minneapolis and that justice would be impartially done in the case of the death of George Floyd. We also ask that this would be a reminder of us, a real-life example, that partiality has no place to play in our society and in your house of worship, the Christian church. May we never look down on another member, guest, or friend and think we're better than they are. And may you forbid us from ever thinking that we can do whatever we want, regardless of the feelings of others. We ask for this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace. Amen.